A very good afternoon and welcome back to the Proactive Studio. Here with me today from Antipa Minerals, it's Managing Director Roger Mason. Roger, good afternoon. Thanks for being here.
Good afternoon, Elisha, and thanks for having me along.
It's interesting to chat, particularly in light of the drilling campaign that's underway over at the wholly owned Minyari Dome Project in WA's Paterson province. Tell us a little bit more about the program and in particular, some of the recent early results.
Oh, sure, Alicia. Look, we released assay results for the first six Geo01 prospect drill holes from our ongoing RC program on our 100% owned Minyari Dome project. And these holes delivered some fantastic intersections, such as 66 metres at 1.4 grams per tonne gold, which included 17 metres at 4.4 grams per tonne and 4 metres at half an ounce per tonne gold, and another drill hit of 20 metres at 2.4 grams per tonne gold, which included 11 metres at 3.4 grams per tonne gold as well. And there were individual 1 metre gold grades were up to as high as an ounce per tonne gold. So these latest Geo01 results continue to highlight further high-grade gold, along with significant volumes of potentially open-pittable lower-grade mineralisation. So we're currently drill testing for extensions to Geo01's high-grade gold mineralisation, plus there are multiple zones of mineralisation which remain open across Geo01's very large 700-metre by 400-metre footprint.
Sounds like it's quite encouraging, even though it is still early days. Roger, you've mentioned quite a bit about Geo01. That deposit there is obviously quite important to the company. Tell us a little bit more about the implications of these results in light of the broader project.
Sure, Alicia. Look, these results continue to support the potential for a significant maiden Geo01 resource. And this resource could boost the economics of the Minyari Dome standalone gold development opportunity by extending the mine life and increasing the cash flow. It's also looking as though Geo01 will provide significant additional open pit gold production. And because open pit mining costs are much cheaper than underground, Geo01 may further improve the project economics by delaying the scheduled commencement of underground production from the Minyari deposit. So very pivotal results indeed.
Always good to hear. There is the potential to curb some of the costs there, particularly when it comes to mining endeavours. Let's talk a little bit more about that phase one drilling program currently underway. You've spoken about it briefly, but can you summarise some of the key objectives for us, Roger?
Certainly, Alicia. Look, the ongoing 2024 phase one drilling program is planned to include up to 80 RC drill holes for approximately 11,000 metres, plus up to three diamond core drill holes for about 3,000 metres. So in total, roughly 14,000 metres of drilling across our 100% owned Minyari Dome project. The phase one program has a dual focus, which is to deliver that maiden Geo01 resource, but also to test multiple high priority targets, including six targets close to our 1.5 million ounce Minyari gold copper deposit, plus the three Pacman geophysical targets, which are located along trend in the 7 million ounce Havieron gold copper deposit. Antipa had $5.4 million in cash at the end of March, and so a phase one program is fully funded, including the Pacman drilling, which is partially supported by WA government exploration grants totaling $440,000. But on top of our 100% program, Alicia, our major partners are also out and about. For example, on our Wilkie project, where Newmont are farming into the tune of $60 million, activities are being completed in preparation for drilling at the exciting Telfer-sized 3 kilometre long by 1.5 kilometre wide Parkland's surface geochemical gold anomaly. This is anomalies located just 10 kilometres from Newmont's giant Telfer gold copper silver mine and processing facility. And also on our Paterson project, where IGO are farming in to the tune of $30 million, Diamond drilling is currently being completed at two Havieron analog coincident magnetic gravity targets located about 10 to 20 kilometres from Minyari. So there's a fair bit going on, Alicia.
It certainly sounds like it. Bottom line here is there's plenty more to explore, but you do have the funding and partnerships to do it. Of course, fitting all of that into a calendar year, particularly one that's going as quickly as 2024, can be difficult. Roger, tell me a little bit more about your vision for the year and how that really aligns with your company strategy.
Yeah, good question, Alicia. Look, Antipa's medium-term goal is to become a profitable gold, copper, silver producer, to benefit our shareholders. So the phase one program aims to deliver that GEO-01 maiden resource around the end of July, following which the current plan is to update the Minyari Dome scoping study during August, with this update having the ability to leverage significantly improved economics. Not only from the additional production opportunity at GEO-01, which may eventuate, but also from the massive increase in the Australian dollar gold price. So, for comparative purposes, in August 2022, our scoping study used a gold price of 2,430 Australian dollars per ounce. And so you can compare that to where the gold price is trading at now, which is over 40% higher at above $3,500 per ounce. So, in terms of the vision for the year, a favourable scoping study update would give Antipa the confidence to commence the Minyari Dome pre-feasibility study, which is the precursor to a definitive feasibility study that could ultimately lead to that mine development decision that we're striving toward.
Good to get a little bit of a long lens on some of those visions and tie it into your projects. Of course, there is a little while to go between now and August. So, over the next couple of months, can you elucidate for shareholders exactly what you plan to accomplish?
Sure, Alicia, the main news flow for investors to be aware of will be from our 100% owned Minyari Dome project. And that includes several releases over the next few months with assay results, for the remainder of our 14,000 metre phase one drill program. Then we'll have the GEO-01 maiden resource planned for completion in July. The refresh of the Minyari Dome scoping study planned for completion in August. A possible announcement of a phase two drill program for the second half of this year, and then a decision on the commencement of the Minyari Dome pre-feasibility study. But on top of all of that 100% news flow, additional news flow will be generated from our three partnered projects with the majors. That's Newmont, IGO, and Rio Tinto, including drill results for our IGO project, plus various other drilling and soil-related programs, possibly including the exciting Parkland's target that I mentioned. And then in the background, on top of all of that significant news flow from our Paterson Province portfolio, there'll be a bit of a buzz of a possible province-scale consolidation slash M&A, with Newmont about to commence a sale process for its combined Telfer-Havieron 5.5 million ounce gold and 220,000 ton copper resource, along with Telfer's massive 22 million ton per annum processing facility. So it's likely that a number of miners will be very keen to acquire Newmont's combined production-ready gold, copper, silver assets. However, Alicia, it's important to appreciate that there's a bit of a catch there in that the Telfer plant runs out of Telfer ore feed within a couple of years, and Havieron will use less than 25% of Telfer's processing capacity. And so it's imperative that the new owner of Telfer de-risks gold production by securing additional future ore feed. So it's worth keeping in mind that Antipa's Minyari open-pittable gold, copper, silver development opportunity is just 35 kilometers from Telfer, and our resource starts at the surface. For comparative purposes, Havieron is 50 kilometers from Telfer, and its resource starts at 430 meters below the surface. And the other part to that equation to remember, Alicia, is that Antipa has a very tight hold on over 5,000 square kilometers of the most explorable wider Paterson District, which has very serious tier one gold, copper, silver discovery and production potential. So, look, all in all, Alicia, investors can expect lots of news flow in the short to medium term, including several possible re-rate catalysts.
Roger, between what's happening across your projects and these partnerships, it seems like the Paterson province is one to watch, and Antipa is right at the centre of it. We're looking forward to another update from you and the team very soon.
Yeah, brilliant. Thanks for your time, Alicia.